Greetings and blessed day to you once again, people of God. It's the Revelator once again, and hoping the grace and the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ is with you until the end of time. We meet once again in yet another spectacular word dimension inside the acts of the Holy Spirit. And the acts of the Holy Spirit is the word ministration of the gospel of truth. We meet once again in yet another sermon presentation. Another presentation that I'm praying that the Holy Spirit is going to usher you into another understanding through the wisdom of the knowledge of the word, the understanding that equips your faith in the things of the Spirit. Today, I want to take you into a presentation that is going to strengthen your foundation inside the Word of God. And today, I want to also expose what is very critical and what I believe is going to touch more on preachers. And today, I want to expose what is called a heresy, or heresies. I'm going to be giving you the definition of heresy. I know that some of you are familiar with that word, but to others you are not familiar. But whenever you hear the word heresy, it is the word that is next to lies. It is the word that is next to blasphemy. It is the word that is next to all manner of deceit inside the doctrine that is not of God. Heresy. So, for us to understand more on heresy, let us get in the book of 2 Peter chapter 2 verse 1. In the book of 2 Peter chapter 2 verse 1, it reads, "But there were false prophets among the people, even as there shall be false teachers among you, who privily shall bring in damnable heresies, even denying the Lord that bought them, and bring upon themselves swift destruction." These words that I've read, they were read by many already, and these words were inspired by Apostle Peter, and this passage is warning of false prophets. Not only is this passage warning of false prophets, it is warning what shall come out of the false prophet, the product of the message which defines them as the false prophet, is what Apostle Peter is warning in this passage. And he's talking about what they shall present as damnable heresies, even denying the Lord that brought them. And before he even goes any further, what we have already investigated inside that scripture is that the fact of denying Christ is a heresy on its own. Before we talk about doctrines or misguided teachings which are theological, what we have already started and came out with is that denying Christ, not accepting that Christ came in the flesh, not accepting that Christ, the anointed, is in the Father and is part of the Father and is the Son under the Father, it's a heresy on its own. So what it means is that false prophets are defined by their message of denying the existence of Christ. That is the first category of a false prophet. Before we talk about categories of false prophets under the season of false Christ, which are the false prophets that come preaching a message that includes the name of Jesus, yet they don't belong to Christ. Now, the scripture there is saying the false prophets who privily shall bring indemnably heresies, even denying the Lord that bought them with a price on the cross, meaning that they shall deny even the cross and bring upon themselves swift destruction in the last hour. And many shall follow their pernicious ways, by reason of whom the way of truth shall be evil spoken of. And through covetousness shall they with feigned words make merchandise of you. Those that shall make merchandise of you, they are also false prophets. And making merchandise of the gospel and using the gospel to merchandise it as a product, as a way of creating income through the merchandise of the gospel. And that type of gospel, it defines another category of heresy. Why? Because there is a certain marketable gospel in that diversity of lies, which only markets a gospel that is heretic. I hope someone is understanding what I'm saying. And through greed, they shall make words. And those words shall not just be words, but merchandise of you, whose judgment now of long time lingereth not, and their damnation slumbereth not. For if God spared not the angels that sinned, but cast them down to hell, and delivered them into the chains of darkness to be reserved unto judgment, what more those that preach heresies on his pulpit? What more those that make merchandise of the gospel? Those that merchandise words, to make merchandise of the gospel is to merchandise words. It means you compile words and you create a sermon, and you theologically create a teaching that doesn't exist, and you construct lies which are called heresies, which do not give evidence of a gospel that is approved by our Lord Jesus Christ. Now, let us go to the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 18. For first of all, when you come together in the church, I hear that there be divisions amongst you, and I partly believe it. For there must be also heresies amongst you, that they which are approved may be made manifest amongst you. Now, those divisions which are being talked today in 1 Corinthians, they're divisions which come about in the Church of Jesus Christ after heresies have been preached by another class. And after heresies have been preached amongst you, there is also a class which must be approved and made manifest amongst you. Why? Because for the truest apostles to be selected or elected, for the truest preachers, teachers, and prophets to be also selected, there must be those that are preaching heresies. And when there are those that are preaching heresies, those that are displaying their heresies, what it means is that we are also going to be able to give a distinction between what is true and what is false. We cannot give a distinction between what is true and what is false when we don't have a standard between lies and the truth. So the false preachers are going to be allowed to be given birth unto in great numbers. They are going to come in their thousands. They are going to come in their multitudes. And when they come in their multitudes, we are going to be able to handpick those that are preaching a standard of a gospel, and they are going to be very scarce. And whilst those that are preaching the truth are going to be very scarce, those that are going to be preaching their heresies are going to be very many. And when they are going to be the majority, what it means is that they are going to be endorsing each other in their lives. It surprises me to learn how the church is functioning through endorsements, whereby if one lie is endorsed by another and another lie is birthed by another endorsement that has been endorsed by another liar, and the system continues parading and protecting a false gospel. And the parading of the false gospel that is being protected by the liars continues, and it builds a formidable body, not of Christ, but of preachers who are liars, of false preachers who preach heresies. I've heard many unusual words that are being preached on the pulpit, which have been endorsed, where preachers endorse each other over certain controversial words that would have been spoken on the pulpit. A level where pulpit lies are endorsed, and the thousands are fed with the poisonous lies. Verily I say unto you, that men shall be judged, utterly judged, for every careless word that they have spoken on the pulpit of God. Now, when you come together, therefore, into one place, this is not to eat the Lord's Supper. For in eating, everyone taketh before other his own supper, and one is hungry and another is drunken. Now, this is not just a supper that is being talked about here. For in eating, everyone taketh before other his own supper. The gospel that you are preaching represents the supper that you have prepared before the table for those that are going to consume your own congregation, the audience that is giving you an ear. But in these classes of audience, in these classes of congregations that are hearing the gospel, one is hungry and another is drunken. What it means is that we have a class of those that are hungry for the word and those that are drunken, those that are preaching things that are coming from the Spirit, and those that are preaching things that are coming from their head, and those that are utterly preaching heresies. They are not different from those that are preaching things that are coming from their head. What you create out of the gospel that you are preaching, if it is not coming from the Holy Spirit, it is a heresy. When you create a theological sermon where you combine words in a very fluent manner, and those words, they are not being projected by the power of the Holy Spirit, they are just empty words which are very sweet to listen to. There are people that are good at preaching 3 to 4, 5 hour sermons. And when they preach sermons that stretch 3 to 4, 5 hours, you believe that they are cracking revelations. Yet these are not revelations which they are cracking. They are cracking lies from the pit of hell. We are talking about heresies, a drunken gospel, where one is preaching, but what they are preaching is intoxicated. It is intoxicated from the pit of hell. What they are preaching, it is not the standard of the Holy Spirit. What they are preaching, it is not the doctrine of the word of Christ. What they are preaching, it is not recommended by the word of Christ. Now, let us go to the book of Galatians, chapter 1, verse 6. And it reads, I marvel that you are so soon removed from him that called you into the grace of Christ unto another gospel. What it means is that there are not just many gospels, but there is only one type of gospel, which is the gospel of Christ. But also, there is not only one gospel. There are many gospels that are not gospels of Christ. And here, Apostle Paul is amazed that you have been moved. You have already been removed from him that called you into the grace of Christ and into another type of gospel, which is not the gospel of Christ. Which type of gospel is that? When you only have the gospel of Christ, he's talking about heresies. Heresies are a compilation of theology, not the spirit. Jesus says these words that I preach, their spirit and their truth. This gospel that I teach, it is not just words. They are not just echoes. No. These words that I speak, they are life. Meaning that behind the words, there was power. There was influence behind the gospel that Jesus was preaching. And that is the genuine gospel. Not other gospels that are preached by lawyers, doctors, scholars. No. Those are not gospel dimensions. Those are theological sentiments. People that just come up after reading their books or starting the Bible like a syllabus. You don't start the Bible like a syllabus. You preach heresies, which is not another, but there be some that trouble you who would want to pervert the gospel of Christ. Those that want to pervert the gospel of Christ are the ones that preach heresies. But though we or an angel from heaven preach any other gospel unto you, which is not what we have preached to you, let him be against them. That is Apostle Paul. He goes to an extent of protecting the gospel that has been preached, the gospel that he has preached, and says, if there be any other that comes to you to preach a gospel which is not in the standard of the word that we have taught you, even if it be an angel, let him be accursed. That level of defending the gospel. But that does it mean that we don't have those that have come with another new fashion of gospel? We have them. There are so many, and they are in their multitudes, that are preaching a gospel that is very unusual, that is weird, that is questionable. They are even comparing the level of defending the gospel at that level to the level that he says, even if it be an angel, that will come with another diversion of gospel, diverting you from the gospel that you have preached, let that angel be accursed. It is a level that is at its own level. Why? Because it doesn't mean that we don't have those that have come opposing the gospel that he preached. There are so many, like I said, that are now presenting a gospel that you don't even understand where it is coming from, which is not even scriptural. Yes, you might come with other revelation dimensions which are not scriptural, but the word that is being inspired by the Holy Spirit will always link up with the scripture. It will always coordinate with the scripture. It will be affiliated with the scripture. So I'm talking about those that come and they want to preach another angle, thinking that they are giving revelation, yet it will be a heresy. As we said before, and that is in Galatians chapter 1, verse 9. So say I now again, if any man preach any other gospel unto you that you have not received, let him be accursed. For do I now persuade men, or God, or do I seek to please men? Any gospel that persuades men, it is a heresy. Any gospel that is not persuading Christ, any gospel that is not persuaded by Christ, any gospel that is not under the influence of Christ, it is a heresy. A heresy is not very far from a blasphemy. It is a lie. For if I yet pleased men, should not be a servant of Christ, but the majority are pleasing men. And they are being endorsed by men. Like I said, the preachers are endorsing each other. As long as they endorse each other, it doesn't matter, it's a lie. They can endorse that heresy and it becomes a standard inside the body of Christ. All those that are preaching heresies shall be utterly judged for every careless word that they have spoken on the pulpit of God. But I certify you, brethren, that the gospel which was preached of me is not after men. For I neither received it of men, neither was I taught it by men, but by the revelation of Jesus Christ. And like I said, they all claim to be preaching a revelation of Christ. Even at the level of comparing themselves with God, even at the level of challenging God, even at the level of mocking God, even at the level of offending God, they don't realize that they are preaching heresies. But I'm praying unto you that you has heard this message, that our Lord Jesus Christ is going to spare you from these false doctrines that don't display the ways of Christ. I pray for you that has understood this message, that you're going to be spared from these heresies. You're going to be spared from these lies. And I'm praying for you that you're going to be spared from the heresies and you're given the gospel of truth in the name of Jesus.